Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to learn hemoglobin buffer and a concept called chloride shift. So this buffer mechanism is the first line defense mechanism in case of acid-base balance. So in this buffer mechanism, there are various buffers like bicarbonate, phosphate. One of the important buffer or intracellular or especially in the RBC, that is hemoglobin buffer. So today we are going to study the mechanism or action of hemoglobin as a buffer. And this is a very important buffer in order to transport oxygen and carbon dioxide. And this hemoglobin buffer works effectively with the bicarbonate buffer system. This bicarbonate buffer plays very important role in the action of hemoglobin buffer. They work together or cooperatively. So when you say action of hemoglobin buffer, it actually takes place in two sites. That is, hemoglobin buffer action in the tissues and hemoglobin buffering action in the lungs. We are going to study both these aspects of action of hemoglobin buffer. First, we will see the action of hemoglobin buffer, especially in the tissue. We know that in the tissue, as a result of metabolism, there is release of carbon dioxide. And in the tissue, there are capillaries which are approaching to the tissue. Here, in the capillaries, we have RBC. And RBC actually carries oxygenated hemoglobin or oxyhemoglobin from the lungs to the tissue in order to deliver this or unload this oxygen to the tissue and take this carbon dioxide from the tissue and carries towards the lungs in order to expel outside. So as a result of metabolism, there is generation of carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide diffuses into the plasma and then on to the RBC. So we have carbon dioxide inside the RBC now. Now this carbon dioxide combines with the water within the RBC to form carbonic acid in presence of carbonic anhydrase enzyme. Since this is an acid, there is immediately it will dissociate to give proton or hydrogen ion and decreases pH. When there is slight decrease in the pH inside the RBC, this oxyhemoglobin dissociates to give deoxyhemoglobin and oxygen, and this oxygen will be released into the tissues. So you can see here, the carbon dioxide which is released as a result of metabolism diffuses to the RBC, and oxygen which is carried by this RBC from the lungs, now it will be unloaded to the tissues. So what will happen here? Since there is more of carbonic acid, this carbonic acid now, because there should not be any decrease in the pH, this carbonic acid immediately buffered by this deoxyhemoglobin. So hemoglobin is a very good buffer because it contains about 38 residues of histidine. Histidine acts as a very good buffer because the pK value of histidine is about 7.3, very close to physiological pH. So this proton which is released from the carbonic acid immediately buffered by this deoxyhemoglobin, and in turn it will give bicarbonate. So whatever excess proton generated as a result of carbonic acid, so the proton will be buffered by this deoxyhemoglobin and there will be release of bicarbonate. So there is going to be accumulation of this bicarbonate. So here I have written potassium because always potassium is intracellular whereas sodium is extracellular. So potassium combines with the bicarbonate. Now this potassium bicarbonate dissociates to give potassium and bicarbonate. So there is going to be accumulation of bicarbonate inside the RBC. So this excess bicarbonate will be going to the plasma of the capillaries here. It will go outside the RBC to the plasma. So remember, where this bicarbonate is coming from? Actually, this bicarbonate is from this tissue carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide will form carbonic acid and it will dissociate to give bicarbonate. Since one anion is going out of the RBC to the plasma, there should be electrical neutrality. In order to maintain electro neutrality, another anion from the plasma, that is chloride, will be coming inside the RBC. So there will be maintenance of electrical charge. So this efflux of bicarbonate and influx of chloride, especially in the near the tissue, is called chloride shift. Remember, whatever carbon dioxide generated as a result of metabolism in the tissue, it will be converted to bicarbonate and now dissolved in the plasma, and through the blood it will be carried to the lungs. So you need to understand, there is unloading of the oxygen and there is transport of carbon dioxide in the form of bicarbonate in the plasma, not in the RBC. So this action is mainly by hemoglobin buffer as well as bicarbonate buffer system. Let's move on to the action of hemoglobin buffer, especially in lungs. So in the alveoli of the lungs, we have sufficient amount of oxygen, and the capillaries surrounding the alveoli contains deoxyhemoglobin. Now this oxygen, which is from the alveoli of the lungs, diffuses to the inside of the RBC and it combines with deoxyhemoglobin to form oxyhemoglobin. You can see this oxyhemoglobin, it has got one extra proton, that is strong acid. So immediately this oxyhemoglobin, or you can say strong acid, dissociate with the help of bicarbonate, which is present inside the RBC now, to give carbonic acid. That means the protons, strong acids or oxyhemoglobin, this protons is immediately buffered by this bicarbonate, potassium bicarbonate present inside the RBC. So again there is generation of carbonic acid. So meanwhile there is utilization of this bicarbonate inside the RBC. Now this carbonic acid, with the help of carbonic anhydrase, dissociate to give water and carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide will be expelled through expiration. See, in the lungs, oxygen will be taken by RBC. In turn, it will form oxyhemoglobin. And we know that from the tissue, carbon dioxide indirectly transported in the plasma in the form of bicarbonate. And this bicarbonate now releasing carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide will diffuse to the alveoli of the lung and it will go outside. So in this process, you might have noticed there is utilization of bicarbonate. That means inside the RBC there is lack of bicarbonate. So from the plasma there is more and more bicarbonate is coming inside the RBC. And this bicarbonate combines with potassium and it will form potassium bicarbonate. And again this bicarbonate utilized to form carbonic acid and it will dissociate to carbon dioxide and this carbon dioxide will be expelled. So whatever this bicarbonate, which is actually originated from the tissue carbon dioxide, and it will be converted to carbon dioxide within the RBC and it will be expelled through the lungs. Since one anion is coming inside the RBC, in order to maintain electro neutrality, another anion should go outside the RBC. So chloride will be going outside the RBC to the plasma. Again, this is called chloride shift. So this is actually the action of hemoglobin buffer, especially in the tissues and in the lungs. In the tissues, it takes carbon dioxide and unloads oxygen with the help of bicarbonate buffer system and hemoglobin buffer system. And in the lungs, actually the oxygen will be transported in the RBC as oxyhemoglobin, and there will be release of carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide is released as a result of metabolism, indirectly transported in the form of bicarbonate. Now this bicarbonate release in the form of carbon dioxide from the RBC to the lungs, and it will be expelled. So this is actually the mechanism of hemoglobin buffer in the tissues and in the lungs. Thanks for watching.